Alright, good afternoon everybody. It's your boy Akeem from the Football Source, here to give you a preview of week 13 of the 2014 college football season. This is a very important week. We are headed around towards the crunch time of the season, and this is going to be some big games for key matches and even big games to even who will determine who will make the college football playoff and even the conference championships. Now, I want to start off with a game of tonight, actually two games for tonight. Number 12 Kansas State is traveling to Morgantown to face the West Virginia Mountaineers. Now, this Mountaineer team has been a big-time sleeper in the Big 12 Conference, and even in college football, they had a couple of close losses this season against TCU, and they fought hard in their first game of the season against Alabama, who's ranked number one in the country. Now, for Kansas State, this is an even more crucial, important game for the Wildcats. They're looking to stay alive and try to clinch at least a share of the Big 12 championship, and even play after the new year. So this is going to be an important battle for Kansas State. But for this game, and I'm going to start off today's blog with an upset game of the week with West Virginia over Kansas State, mainly because West Virginia has been playing pretty good this season, particularly at home, despite their loss against TCU 31-30. Next game on tonight, UNC is going to be playing against Duke. Now, Duke lost last week in an upset game against Virginia Tech, and they're looking to bounce back and stay alive in the Coastal Division of the ACC Conference. They're tied up with Georgia Tech. Now, this week, they're playing against a UNC defense who has allowed 41 points per game. I think the Blue Devils should definitely pull off the win in this matchup, and even a big win for them because UNC did beat Georgia Tech this season. Headed over to the Big Ten Conference, number 6, Ohio State University is going to be playing against Indiana on Saturday. Now, Ohio State has a very favorable schedule before headed towards the Big Ten Championship. They should win out with these last two games, and then they're going to start off against the Hoosiers. Staying in the Big Ten, number 23, Nebraska is going to be hosting number 25, Minnesota. Now, last week, the Cornhuskers was just ran all over by Melvin Ingram and that high-powered rushing attack for on Wisconsin Badgers, and Melvin Ingram broke a college record with 408 yards rushing by himself. Now, this week for the Cornhuskers, they're facing another good feature back in David Cobb for the Gophers, and I'm going to go with an upset in this one. My second upset this week, I'm going to have to go with Minnesota over Nebraska. Next game, headed over to the Pac-12 Conference, Arizona State is going to be hosting Washington State. Arizona State lost last week. They're looking to bounce back, and they're actually in a four-way tie for the Pac-12 South title with UCLA, USC, and Arizona. And Arizona State is looking to stay alive and possibly make it to the Pac-12 championship. I think this should be an easy win at home against Washington State. Next game, the number 3 Florida State is going to be hosting Boston College. Now, Boston College earlier this season, they did upset USC. I highly doubt that they're going to do the same against the Noles. I'm going to have to go with the Seminoles over the Eagles. Next game is actually going to be in the MAC conference between two good teams, 7-3 Western Michigan against 7-4 Central Michigan. Now, Western Michigan Broncos host a great freshman running back who is actually leading the conference in rushing, and Javarian Franklin, who has over 1,300 yards rushing. I'm going to have to go with the Broncos over Central Michigan. Next game, headed over to the SEC Conference. Number 8, Ole Miss is going to be traveling to Arkansas to face the Razorbacks. Now, for Arkansas, they finally pulled off their first SEC win last week in a shutout win over LSU. They can't pull the upset against the Rebels, but they play terrible in their pass defense. I think that Bo Wallace will light them up, despite the fact that he's losing his best offensive weapon and Laquon Treadwell. I still think because of Ole Miss defense, they will hold things up against Arkansas. Next game, headed back to the Pac-12 Conference. Number 15, Arizona is going to be traveling to Utah to face number 17, the Utah Utes. Utes has been a surprise team in the Pac-12 Conference this season. A 7-3 record overall. Have a couple of great pass rushers with the nation's leading sack leader and Nate Orchard. He's having a dominant year. He's actually tied up with fellow Pac-12 player Haloi Kikaka out of Washington. I think that Orchard in that pass rushing attack is going to be too much for Arizona. I'm going to have to go with the Utes over Arizona because of their defense. Next game, Iowa's going to be hosting number 16, Wisconsin. Now, I mentioned Melvin Ingram. They are now the front runners of the West Division for the Big Ten Conference and make it to that championship. They definitely had to run the table for the last two games of the season and with a big win over Iowa. Number 24, Louisville is going to be traveling to Notre Dame to face the Fighting Irish. Now, Notre Dame has three losses this season, 7-3, good record, but they had a couple of close losses against Northwestern last week, 43-40 in overtime, and they lost in a close one at Tallahassee. And because of that big loss, that close loss last week against a winless scoring team record for Northwestern, they're actually 4-6 overall. They're not having a winning season, and I think that Louisville's going to light them up, even though Notre Dame is hosting the Cardinals. Next game, a rivalry matchup in California as the Cal Bears host Stanford, a great Stanford defense against a great California offense. I'm going to have to go with the offense in this one. I think that the Golden Bears and quarterback Jared Goff is going to light that defense up, and I'm not really feeling the Cardinals offense with Keith Hogan at the helm at quarterback. I'm going to have to go with the Bears over the Cardinals. Last game, number 20, Missouri is going to be traveling to Knoxville to face the Tennessee Volunteers. Now, Missouri controls their own destiny in the Eastern Division. In the East Division for the SEC Conference, they have Tennessee and Arkansas as their final two games, and I think they should definitely beat the Vols in this one, keeping things alive, but they're going to have a big scare in the next game against Arkansas. So I'm going to have to go with Missouri Tigers over the Tennessee Volunteers, keeping them alive in the Eastern Division. Now, the next time I'm going to catch you guys will be tomorrow, where I will give you a one-on-one preview with my game of the week. Number 19, USC, at number 9, UCLA. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thank you for watching today's blog. From the Football Source, I'm Emmanuel Keenan McCall. Be easy.